Hi guys, if you're watching this, just doing a quick stream. You'll hear some music in the background. It's just a chill out stream. Mainly focusing on some code and that. Might actually just get to the link for our live chat so I can see things a little bit better. So there's no delay. I'm gonna turn the volume off. And just quickly just going over some bits and pieces really in the code. So basically, if there's any questions, some streaming, you guys can kind of just like ask some questions. If anyone watches, of course, you can do that. And let us know your thoughts on that. So there's a bit of a delay in the stream, but hopefully you'll be able to ask me what you need to ask me. I don't know how long I'm going to stream for, just because, as I said, I'm just doing this kind of as I'm coding anyway. So, you know, you can ask me stuff as we go along. Not really worried if anyone actually watches, I'm just going to put it up anyway, because I can. So what am I up to on Nemesis at the moment? Just kind of doing bits and pieces of code for the actual events themselves. We've got some cool buff changes that are going on. There is, if I can find it, a kind of spreadsheet that I originally set up on my drive. Kind of goes over some of the abilities that are going to be in Nemesis, and essentially different chains, because they're in different chains, they're having the different percentages of the events. So basically you're looking at the entity manifest at the moment, or I am, that's what I'm looking at, and that kind of goes over things. Hi Sam, how you doing? That kind of goes over all of the sort of main items, if you like, of everything that loads in the game. So essentially every one of these files is an actual file in STA3 that loads as we play the game. And so anything that we add obviously goes up to the top, we add the number in. That's what makes the mod work. So essentially you need the entity manifest as kind of like your central point. That's your central point to kind of get everything running in the game. That's what loads everything when you load a map. So every time you guys are watching that loading bar, this is part of what's happening. It's loading every one of these entity files as it goes along. So to give you an example, we've got rapid fire disruptor here. If I can find it, I don't know if I have. It's loading this particular file here, which as you can see is then laid out and then provides information to the engine. So the engine itself will then look at this file and then code it in. So that's kind of the long and short of it, and it's quite cool because all of this code, everything that I've ever done in STA3 and that my fellow devs have ever done, is translated into the game that you play when you play this mod. And it goes for the same for Ascendancy as well. From doing Ascendancy, it's the same kind of code base, obviously, because it's exactly the same engine. So I can translate a lot of the stuff that I do in STA3 into Ascendancy and vice versa. So every bit of these files is what loads into the game. It's whatever what Corey does, what I do, what Cronus does, what Gul does. These files are kind of central part of it. So for today, I'm working, as I said, on the Nemesis base. And the Nemesis base is a pretty far out concept. So I'm gonna drag some a file over there so you guys can see this. So you can get like an understanding. Now, hi Klaus, how you doing? Hi Ice, by the way. Hi Neridin. This concept is that there are three main chains. So restore, damage and power. And these are the percentage healths that each chain will kick in. Now these are cumulative, so we have a what we call a looped cycle. That essentially, if the station was to heal itself up and trigger over, it would then also be able to re-trigger the ability once it goes back down under that health percentage. So obviously the reason for dividing up to categories is just to make it a little bit easier on me to actually remember exactly how I'm programming this particular event. And the reason this event is kind of like so much more complicated than any other event is that there are a lot of chains and buffs off of buffs off of buffs because the station requires it. So it's pretty crazy. Let me know, guys, if my volume's all right as well, because obviously I'm aware I've got music on as well in the background. Chain 1 obviously restore, we've got the shield restores, we've got the repair drones, and these spawn at different percentages. We have damage, which does 4 on shockwave, rapid fire disruptors, and then these alternate up to this. And then we have the power chain, which is a little bit less because it's quite powerful, being the power chain. Essentially, we've got spawn frigates, we've got EMP pulse, that are going to fire off at different percentages. And then we have this fourth ability, which is just called Titan Killer, which is Zap. Let's just give a hint what happens if you try to take your Titans near the station, Mr. Klingon players. Don't be counting on the shockwave to help you out. And then we have a fifth ability called the Game Ender, which I haven't coded yet, but again, is another chain. So each one of these will fire off. So if I give you an example of one that's already done, that I've already coded in, we've got the damage chain here. We each have the actual buffs that apply to each. So we have 2 for 4 on. Then we have the damage chain itself. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we have rapid fire strike number 6. And the way it works is the ability itself, which is called damage, is here. This just literally applies a buff to self, which in this case is the damage self buff. So it's applying it to the station, which then applies the self chain. I'm not going to show you the self, but that basically applies the chain one. And here's the chain one. Now, chain one is where it gets interesting. Chain one splits because in Sims, what modders have to do is we have to work around the engine. And the engine itself has a few issues in that you can only support 5 instant actions at once. So if you want to do more than 5 things in a file, we don't need to split the file now. So essentially I've got 2 instant actions here. So these apply instantly, hence the name instant action. We've got damage chain states and damage chain states 2. Okay. If we look at chain states as a whole, what you'll see is a lot more instant actions. We've got our loop, our cyclable, which is damage chain 1. It points back to damage chain 1. This is basically saying that you need to apply this buff again to the first chain of first spawn. The reason we do that is we need to tell the engine that this buff is constantly applying. It's going around in a circle, okay? It's looking at the percent constantly. And that's why that first in action exists, to apply that particular set of instant actions again. So the chain one, obviously, if you remember, points to this chain. So it's just like a cyclable. It's going to go around in a circle. We then have an apply buff to first spawn and no filter, no range. That basically means applying a buff to the station. The station spawned the ability, spawned the buff, it's going to apply that buff to it. So the buff is going to apply. It's going to do the 4 on shockwave self. And again, what we can see here is that we have, when you make up this instant action, we've got the type, which is applying to itself, which we just spoke about. The condition, so the on condition, and the condition type, which is if owner has hull less than a certain percentage. Yeah, so what we want to do is we want to tell the station that if you have less than this health, then you're going to do this. Okay, so in this case, if it has less than 90% health, you're then going to apply the 4 and shockwave self. And if we go then to 4 and shockwave self, we can see that again has warriors to action, so that's going to apply a buff to targets in a radius of the station. You can see then how it applies that. So it's doing it on a delay. The delay we have is 0, so it's going to do it instantly, pretty much. What is it going to apply? It's going to apply this buff, again, another bit of the chain, 4 on shockwave. Okay, and the way it's going to work, it's going to target, and the filter for target is enemy ships. So it's going to target enemy ships. And then it's going to target specific objects, because we have to tell the engine what objects it's going to target. Hi Khan, by the way, good to see you. So we're telling it that we want to target capital ships, planet modules, starbase, Titan, Corvette, frigate. The reason we got planet module, starbase in there is because there are deployables which count towards that count. So if you think about like some of the ships deploy turrets and stuff like that. We then want to choose the space, because in Sims there is phase space and normal space. So in this case we're applying it in a normal space. And the constraints. So not self, not invulnerable. So if something's invulnerable, it's not going to apply the damage to an invulnerable ship.
Yeah.
The range, 12,000, quite a big range on this one. So you're not going to be able to steer your ships necessarily out of the foreign shockwave itself. So quite a lot of range. And the max target count, now because it's set to minus one, what that actually means is it'll hit everything in that range no matter what. You can actually set a specific target count, which is what a lot of abilities in Ascendancy and STA3 have. So they have, like, you can only hit 8 ships. Because obviously some abilities, if they're hitting everything, it'd just be OP. So this one in particular hits everything. It's going to hit your entire fleet if it's within that 12,000 range. And then the effect, so this is where we start adding in our particle effects and particle forge. In this case, we've already got one built called Foreign Shockwave. Is there any period actions? No, no overtimes, no entity modifiers. And the finish condition, because you have to have a finish condition. In this case, all on delay instant action is done. So this will finish once this action is done. Now, we spoke a bit earlier, we said that this points to another buff in the chain. And in this case, it's pointing to Foreign Shockwave, which I have here. And then again, this has more instant actions, so this is going to apply an attached effect. I haven't actually got an effect for this yet, but I was thinking about having some kind of glow on the ships for a little while. Once they get hit, something like that. And then we have an instant action of doing damage. So it's going to do 500 damage to every ship in that Foreign Shockwave. It's quite a lot of damage. So something to bear in mind when you're facing off against that ability. And that's one, just one ability. Bear in mind, that's just one ability on one percentage type. Because again, remember, if we go back to our chain states, this is applying on 90%, 80% we've got one applying, 70% we've got one applying, 60% we've got one applying. And again, we've got different abilities that apply to each. So we've got four there. And that's just chain states one. Because there's a limit of five, we've had to create chain state two. And chain state two, again, very similar, 50, 40, 30, 20% applies another set of buffs. And that's just, remember, one chain. That's just this chain here all the way to the end. So our entire chain, I'm just gonna green that because I know it's done. This entire damage chain here, that's just all of the files that relate to that one chain. So hopefully that's making sense. I know it's not the most exciting thing, but it's really important because obviously that's what makes that particular game code work. And it's the same for all kind of abilities, all kinds of ships. So yeah, I would say, you know, you have to take all this in mind when you're building abilities. So for today, I'm just gonna be doing some coding. You guys feel free to stick around, ask questions. You know, chill out with me. Anything you want to know, just ask. Anything else you want to talk about in the chat with me. That's cool. But first of all, I need to actually get on with actually getting up some of the other abilities. I don't think, if I remember right, I've done much in the way of the restore chain anyway. So I'm just going to check, did I do much? I did do some files. I've made some files earlier, but I don't think I've actually finished any of them anyway. So we've got damage chain states. So let's have a look at what we've got here. So then buff restore self. There's my restore self. I'm just going to move these things along. In fact, should I put these in a different view? Let's split these over to a different view. Move this one to a different view. So yeah, it's going to go to restore self. Restore self is going to go to chain one. Pretty simple stuff so far. Looking all correct. Restore chain one is going to go to restore chain states. There's restore chain states, which I've already made. And then this is where I actually need to actually check, because I don't think I've made the abilities themselves. So I don't think, if I go searching through my files here, and I actually look and type nem underscore buff underscore shield, there is no such file as a shield restore. Okay, so I do think though, we do have some shield abilities that we've already made at some point. So let's just have a look. Let's see what other abilities I've already made previously. Let's have a look. Have I got any shield restore files? I can't remember which ships. You guys might remember which STA3 ships had a shield restore now. I think it may be the self shield. Is it the Ambassador? Maybe had one. Let's have a look. Did the Ambassador have a self shield restore? Last stand. Remodulate shields. There you go. F ability remodulate shields. Let's see what that one did. Remodulate. And this is the great thing about once you've already made codes. A lot of the time you can just reuse your own code from before. So what did F buff and modulate shields do? Restore shields. There you go. So that's the that's kind of the token, what we want to do. But we can't use an ability within a buff. It doesn't work. So we need to make another buff file that's basically going to spawn that ability. So there's a great way of doing this. We've already made one for the other chain. So we made Shockwave, Foreign Shockwave. We talked about that earlier. We had this self buff here. There it is. So we're going to use the same thing, basically, and create like a clone of this. And we don't want it, though, to apply a buff to a target radius. And this is where we need to change the type of instant action type. So let me get my Sin's Death view. This is made by Zombie Rust, by the way, the guy that makes Fall of Cobalt. He actually made this for all the modders. He's a really good guy, because otherwise I'd have to write all this down, just to remember. So this is a really cool little Python program that we can just look at the structures of buffs, or our cheat sheet, if you like, just to make things really quick. So big shout out to Zombie for doing this and coding up. He used to build a wiki on a page, but it kept getting shut down, so he's just made it into a program. Yeah. So we need, what was I doing? Instant action structures. So if we make this a little bit smaller, so you guys can see, we have our instant action here. This is apply buff to target radius. All right. So we don't want to apply a buff to our enemy targets. We want to boost their shields. We want to boost our own shields. So the kind of one we want to probably do, again, is apply a buff to self. So there's our chain there. Apply buff to self. So all we need to do, coming back to our target, is very simply apply a buff to self. Now, before I go too far, I am just going to save this because I don't want to overwrite my other file. So again, it's very important that we save this in the right way. Hi Cody, good to see you. So in this case, I'm just going to call it what it is, basically, which in this case is going to be nem buff remodulate, should we do it restore shield? I think that's a little bit easier for typing. So we'll do restore shield dot entity. It's really important that we code it as an entity file. It's not a text file. It's going to be a tile of all types that only Sims will understand. So now we have this restore shields, and we're applying a buff to self. We need to now follow through. So again, I want to take you guys through this bit by bit. So we're going to do it as an on delay, okay? And we've already got an on delay, so it's fine there. What buff are we going to apply? Well, we're going to apply nem buff. Again, we haven't made the file yet, so we need to do that. We'll call it restore shields. I'll call it action. There you go. Restore shields action. Okay. So normally I'd actually call this restore shield self, so I'm just being a bit sloppy, but we'll tidy this up later. The ownership, obviously, that can't be in there. All right, because there is no, if you like, need for an ownership if we're applying a buff to oneself, yeah? So all this stuff here, right, starting out range, none of that is going to be nilled, nor is the target filter. But the effect info is, because there might be, say, an effect. That's all right, Cody, no worries. Not everyone's interested in the code inside, and that's fine. So what we're trying to show here is that I've lost my file now. What we're trying to show here is that we can apply an effect. We don't want this effect because this is a shockwave effect, so we're just gonna blank it off for the moment. And Once we've done that, we can save our file. So basically, we now have a file that's going to apply a buff to self with an effect info when all on delay interactions are done. And it's going to restore shields, okay? So again, if we go back to our buff over here, we can see that we already have like the perfect buff already pre-made for us from our F buff remodulate shields, which is on the ambassador, okay? So in this case, all we need to do is, again, this is a perfectly good buff. There's no reason to change it, because all it does is restore shields. Obviously, we just change the amounts for the station. So, but what we need to do is we just need to do a file, save as again. Very, very simple. We're going to call this nem underscore buff. And we're going to call it, what did we say? Restore shields action. Restore shields action dot entity. And that there, nem buff restore shield action dot entity, is going to give us the file that we need to get started with. We're going to delete out some of these effects. We could leave them in actually to test. It wouldn't make a difference. They just show up Federation effects. Be a bit weird on a Klingon station though, wouldn't it really? But we could just take those off there again, blank them out. And you can see that this finishes after a time, so it's going to restore those shields, and the shield restore rate is going to be this amount over time. Okay. So we've got that bit done. We've got the buff restore shields. We've got the buff restore shields action. That's all really important so far. But now what we need to do is go back to our restore chain and just check that we've got it all right. So we actually called this restore shields with an S. And this is shield restore is here. So what we're going to do, we're just going to find our shield restore. We're just going to do a replace. Very, very simple. We're going to call this restore shields. It's very important that case sensitivity is right on this. So we're going to replace all there and save that file, because the as far as SIDS is concerned, if that doesn't exist, then we're going to have an issue, if you like. Yeah, we're going to have an issue. So that is our restore shields added. The other one we had in there, we've got to do a kind of repair drone setup. So again, we want to have a look at what the repair drone entails, if you like. So in this case, we've got to think of a ship that already has some kind of repair drone. I know a really good example of one, which I'm going to show you quickly. So something that does launches repair drones, if you like. Drones that are going to restore shields. So if we think of a very popular Borg ship, in this case the Progenitor Titan, we can look at the abilities that this one has. You see that it's got these progenitor probes, which are here. But again, we can find this file. This is the great thing, as I said, we can just reuse code that we've already made before rather than reinventing the wheel. We could reinvent the wheel, but why bother if you've already got some of the code? So in this case, as you know, we've got two steps to making this work. We want the station at a percentage to spawn these probes. So in this case, what it's doing is it's actually creating a frigate, okay? So the progenitor actually spawns, as you know, four little Borg probes that heal it up. And each of those frigates that spawn, okay, will have their own ability. So essentially now we've got a chain within a chain within a chain within a chain that spawns a frigate that has its own abilities, which have its own buffs and its own chains. And that's how complex things can get. I'm going to change my song quickly. A bit too heavy for my liking today. A bit of chill out. What can we find? Some good music. There we go. Right. So, we're going to create this frigate. So, again, we just use the file. But we don't want to create that particular. We don't want a Borg probe popping out of a Klingon station. So, what am I thinking? I'm thinking possibly that we use a specific model. Perhaps we use the Klingon bombers. They could be good drones. Or maybe we have the Klingon station actually spawn actual frigates from the Klingon lineup. So perhaps it will spawn Borels. Healing Borels. Because we can do that. And that's the great thing about coding in this way. So this won't be an ability. We can't have an ability within a buff. So we need to call this a buff. We need to create the file again. We're just going to save it and then edit it out to a buff file. So in this case, we will call this nem buff. What did we call it in our chain? Before we save it, what did we call it? We called it nem underscore repair drones. So we need to call it. I don't know why we didn't put a buff on there. So Bane's terrible pre-planning has not called things right. So then buff underscore repair drones dot entity will be a thing. Okay. So we're gonna save this quickly as repair drones dot entity. So now we have our own file again, so it's not gonna affect the progenitor. We can say goodbye to the progenitor, we don't need that. Bye-bye progenitor. But this file isn't going to work for us. It's a type of an ability, and abilities don't work, as we said. So we need to create, by moving it back to the area, we need to create a file that will do the same as this, but as a buff. Okay, so we need to try and find a buff. And thankfully, because since that's pretty easy to do, so we have a buff here called Create Frigate. Okay. So you're gonna say, well, Bane, like, how do we get this going? You know, how do we start this off? So let me just grab another file that we had earlier again. If you can find it, he says. So many files open, never enough files. Let's see if we can find that now. List. I don't think we're gonna find it. So let's have a look. So there's our Forest Shockwave Self, my favourite file. So this is a buff file. We can see that it's a buff file. And again, we need to make it do what this does. Okay, that we want it to, sorry, what this one does. So we need to make this ability into a buff. Okay. So very, very simply, I don't know why I closed my new one, because I need to copy that. We're going to need our file again. So in this case, the buff instant action type will be, very simply, create frigate. So here we go, create frigate. Okay. Again, we're going to leave it as on delay. Again, we need to say another buff. What buff type is it going to be doing? It's not really doing a buff type. Instead, if we're going to use create frigate, we need to use the frigate type dot entity. So I think we have a lot of this already here. So here it is. So we can just again copy this. Okay. Again, we don't need this buff type bit. We don't need any of this, really. So the frigate type, again, we can follow this through. These are frigate types here, just so you guys can see. Frigate type, num frigates. Match owner damage state, impulse, expiry time, spawn frigate, sound ID. So, again, expiry time, spawn frigate, sound ID. I don't know if it has post-spawn buff. Is that in there? That is in there as well. So post-spawn buff. So again, all of this stuff that was in our ability file, very simply, the only difference is just the start of the file and how the game reads these files and understands as an engine how to use them. So our expiry time. So just indenting things. Indenting doesn't matter too much to our files. It's just more for cleanliness. Spawn frigate, sound ID, postman buff. Okay. So, looking good so far. Do we need anything else in there? We don't need anything else in there. There's no need for an effect info or a sound ID. So that stuff can go. Because as we can see, that's the end. There's nothing after that. So this means we're left with the rest of our file. And the thing it's going to produce, what is it going to produce? The frigate type it's going to produce. Well, we don't have that yet, so we're going to create that in a second. So again, we need to give this a name. Nem underscore buff underscore repair drones action entity. No, actually, we don't need to. We just need to actually oversave this one because that was an ability. So we can actually oversave that file. There we go. Let me close this one down. I want to save that. There we go. Save again. Remember, we've got to add the dot entity bit. If we don't add the dot entity bit, it's not going to work in the game. Is there going to be a new race? There are no more spaces. As much as we'd like to add a new race, there is a limit to what the engine will support at this point. Other people get around it by having like races within races. What you can do to add additional races to activate what we call submods, so you can actually have 8 races if you like, 10 races if you like. But the only way to do that is to actually have a completely separate mod folder structure, so you have like a bit like in Sins of Galactic Empire, you have multiple mod folders, which kind of works, but it's not something that we're keen to do. To be fair, STA3 is an old mod now, a bit like, so it's come to the sort of the end of its life. What I can say is that as well as Infinities, there is other stuff being worked on, but I can't tell you anything else other than that, because I'll be killed by the rest of the dev teams that are involved. But there is something else outside of STA3, and I'm not talking about Infinities. So stay excited, that's what I say, stay excited. But my job really is to get Nemesis working with Draconis and Gul, and so that's what I'm focusing on at the moment, Striker. We've got our file now. We still need to create. Did I save that as repair drone? Oh, I've done it again. I saved the wrong file. I meant to have this one selected. So this is repair drones. This one here, I don't know why I did that. There we go. Right, so this file here is what the one I want to save as repair drones. Bane, what is wrong with you today? It's too date modified. Nem buff repair drones. There we go. We'll get it right in a minute, ladies and gentlemen. We will. All types. Save, yes, replace it. I can't replace, of course, because I've opened this one now. Let's try that again. This one is definitely selected. We'll get past just saving the file in a minute, I promise. It didn't take this long when making the game. So, repair drones we've got, but we need a frigate type for this. So we can't just take, believe it or not, a Klingon frigate. And the reason we can't just take a Klingon frigate, it's a Klingon frigate. We don't get a Klingon frigate. So let's look. Let's call the Burrell. Let's see if we can find it. Is it under Burrell? There it is. Let's just take the Burrell as an example. Okay. The Burrell, while it's a frigate file, has its own set of abilities. So if we were just put this in, it's not going to do what we necessarily want it to do, which is heal the station. Yeah. So what we're going to do is, again, very simply, we're going to take this, we're going to save it as a new file. So in this case, again, this is going to be nem underscore frigate Burrell drone. And we're going to save that. Again, it's still an entity file, it's no different. We're going to save that Brill drone file. So now we have a copy, okay? Everything else can stay the same, all the references and that. The only things we do want to get rid of is the cloaking. We don't want the drones to cloak in this case. I'm just going to save it again. So we now have our Nem Frigate underscore Brill drone. And we can go back to our file here. And we can change the frigate type to Nem underscore Frigate underscore Brill drone. And that then means that we will be spawning this instead of the Borg probes, okay? Now, we mentioned about the Borg probes. The Borg probes can still give be some use to us, okay? So we had the progenitor probes, they were spawning. If we go back to the primitive file, they were spawning the prog probe. So if we find the prog probe, let's have a look at the prog probe. These were the progenitor probes, and they had, of course they did, their whole adapt ability here. So this might be useful for us. We'll have a look, see if it's any good. If not, we'll use a different heal. So again, we're going to look at the ability. What does this ability do? Always perform. Apply targeted buff to self. What's it applying? It's applying this whole adapt activate. So I think this is actually just a carbon copy, if I remember right, of the adapter's ability. Again, we can have a look at all these files. What is it doing? It's applying B buff whole adapt on target. And again, follow the file through. So all it's actually doing, this one, is restoring hull points and a restoring of the hull. And so you've got all this chain here activated. But the reason we want to look at this chain in particular is because it holds something that is really important to me for the thing that I want to do now. It's playing, and you can see it here in this instant action, it is playing a persistent beam effect. So what it's actually doing is it's firing a constant beam at its target, which is healing that target. Now, if we didn't have all these pre-files here, as in the free files, we wouldn't be able to target it, because again, we'll follow it through. We've got the ability file, which is telling it what to target. Again, we can't use an ability, so we'd have to save this again as a buff, okay? So we've got that, and that's telling it what it can target, okay? How much antimatter it costs, the cooldown time, etc., etc. We then have the whole adapt activate. So this is the first chain. This is the bit that's saying play this beam effect and apply a buff to target no field no range, because it's already applied to the target. And it's doing this buff. So it's playing that beam. It's going bzzz. And this file is the file that is, one, playing a sound. Two, playing, restoring actual hull points, and then doing an overtime action where it's restoring hull over time. So that is a triple whammy there, isn't it? We've got the buff we need to make, the buff that's actually playing the effect at the target, and then the buff that's actually doing the part that we need it to do, which is, in this case, we want it to target the station with a beam, our Brill drones, and heal the station up. Now, for you as players, why is this important that you know this? Because this will trigger, remember we go back to our graph, this is why I get really excited about code, because people are like, oh, code is not that exciting, right? Remember that these drones are gonna spawn in the Nemesis encounter at 70%, at 40, at 50%, and at 30%. So essentially, you've got three phases, like any boss fight, like any game you play, whether it be World of Warcraft as an MMO, whether it be Halo Wars, where you're facing up to different bosses, right? These are trigger points. So we have these three trigger points that are gonna spawn from what we've just made, four drones around the station. And these drones are gonna heal the station. Now you as a player then have to react to that, because they're gonna restore a lot of hull. So you as a player, when you're playing Nemesis, when you're doing the encounter, when you're playing that map with your friends, and you're fighting the station, you're going to have to focus down those drones, because if you don't focus down the drones, they're going to heal it up again. Now remember what we said about the looping. If it heals up again, it's going to go past the trigger points, and then when you do attack it down again, it's going to trigger all the abilities again. So if it heals up from repair drones at 70% and it heals over 80%, what will it do? Well, when you get it under 80%, it's going to trigger the shield restore again. It's going to trigger the rapid fire disruptors. If you left the drones there and you managed to out damage the drones even, there's a chance that it could spawn the second set of drones, and then you've got 8 drones to deal with. So even in terms of balancing as a coder, we've got to get this balance right. We've got to make sure that it's a challenge. We don't want it to heal up too quickly, but we don't want you guys to be able to outstrip the drones. But you need to deal with the drones. So the drones are going to be a part of phase, if you like, that will test you as a player, because if you don't take them out, as we said, the station will heal up. And that prolongs your fight. And then again, how long can your own fleet survive the punishing firepower of the Nemesis Revenge? And this is where it's going to be really tricky. We're going to be fiddling. We're going to get these files created, yes. But then we're going to be fiddling with the numbers as developers for a good while to come. This is why Nemesis isn't going to be out just like that, because it's going to need testing to make sure that it's, one, a challenge, and two, that it's not too much of a challenge, and three, that it's fun to actually go against this boss fight. So we've got that need to get this right, and for you guys as players to understand how the event works. And that's part of the fun, is working out when you have to deal with certain things in the event. And hopefully you guys will see that, and all the effort that's gone into creating such an event. Okay? Anyway, I've done a lot of talking, then we need to get back to doing some actual coding. So we said that we've created our frigate barrel drone. We'll move this over to our other view again. There's our frigate barrel drone. We need to create this ability for it. So we are going to nick this ability, but again, we just can't nick a brand new ability. We need to create a new ability file once again. So again, we're going to go back to our file types. This is a buff that we're looking for. So it's an applying a targeted buff to self. So let's have a look if we can find that. Have we got an apply targeted buff to self? Yes, we have. There's our apply target buff to self. So again, we need to recreate this. Okay. Again, really good. We can use one of the ones that we made earlier. Let's not use that one. Let's use. Let's go back to our foreign shockwave self. So let's copy this again into a new file. And then we're going to look at our ability hull adapt. So we know in this case we need to do an apply of a targeted buff to self. So we're applying that buff, okay? And what's that buff going to do? Well, in this case we're going to call this nem_buff_drone_activate. Activate the drones. Carl, what was the answer to the race question? Simply that we could add more races in, but we're not going to for STA3 because that would require us to split the mod up into lots of folders, and you guys would then have to load individual folders. And that's not something you want to do. However, there is something else being worked on, but I can't talk about it, and it's not Infinities. Okay. So where were we? Yeah, so we're doing a targeted buff to self. The instant ship fight is going to stay as on delay, which is just, it's the same as always before, but in this case for buffs we need to do it on delay action. We've got the buff type. What else do we need to do? Target filter. There is a target filter in this one. We can copy the target filter here, very very simple. In, there's our target filter. So I think really we just gonna want, because there's too many here, we don't need capital ships, we don't want the drones to heal themselves, We do possibly want them to heal planet modules. Wink, wink. Titan and Corvette. No. We don't want to do that. So we need to set our numb objects down to two. The constraints, not self, has hull damage. That's obviously going to trigger them to heal. No joke. We could set that up as a thing that they're going to heal each other, but really, I want to make the drones pretty tough. So their idea will be to heal the station, not themselves. You know? So we want them to do that. Want them to heal that. Maybe we'll give us the weapons though, because they're still drones. So we've got a target filter in there. The range, we still need the range. We don't need all this other stuff. So again, we're going to take all this other stuff away. Okay. We just need, again, we can look back at this ability here. We just need the range. There's our range. What's the range going to be? 4,000 in this case is fine. Because we want them to stick pretty close to the station. Is there any effect? Again, in this file, no, because this is not where we would want an effect anyway. Because remember what we said, the effect doesn't need to be applied when this activates on the ships themselves, because that's an effect on the ship. We want the effect to apply a beam, pew pew beam, at the station. Okay? So no effects are needed there, but we still have to leave the effect info in. Otherwise, it won't work. There's no way to tell the AI as such when to use it. They'll just use this because long story short, this isn't an ability, so they'll just use this. So they'll be pretty dumb, the AI, with it, but they will target. If we tell them to target these, they will heal these, yeah? And then, because we've got the constraint has hull damage, they'll use that to target, and that's what we're banking on, if you like. So as you see, we've got everything we want. There's nothing else in that structure. Again, I want to show you this so that you guys can see that it's very easy to code. And so we've got our first file. That's our first file done again. So we're gonna do a save as, and we're gonna have nem underscore buff underscore, what were we gonna call this? We were gonna call this repair drones activate, wasn't it? Repair drones. I'll get all these spellings right in a minute. Activate dot entity. I've just realised, you know what, we don't even need to do that, because it is going. You know, this one can actually be an ability, believe it or not. So that one is actually not needed at all. Look, even Bane gets it wrong. It's terrible when Bane gets his own files wrong. Thinking about it, and the reason I'm gonna correct myself now, we can actually just resave this file, because we can do it as an ability. And the reason we can do it as an ability is it's going on a ship. I think it's going on the station. It's not going on the station, it's going on the ship. So in this case, this could be nem ability underscore, and that means the AI target will work fine. So repair drone activate dot entity. And we can save that. So, and the reason we can do that is we can then put it straight into our repair drone here. We can actually add the ability. This is how you add abilities. Name ability, repair drone activate dot entity. Oh no, I don't need dot entity because that's a file. There we go. So there's our ability added to the ability. So we could add more abilities to the drones if we want to. Maybe we will. Who knows? Give them some cool stuff. So there we go. We've got the repair drone to activate added to the actual repair drone. Let's move this over to the other view. All looking good. This isn't going to be needed. It's not going to have a Borg name or a Borg description. And it's not even going to need an icon, because you're not going to be able to capture these. So, and to make sure you're not going to be able to capture them, there is a very important ability that we already have made up, which is... There it is, G ability uncapped, just have to remember how it was spelt. So G, because this is the other thing that I often forget, is that some things need to be uncapturable. So this uncap ability here is what we put on ships that we don't want to be captured. And what it does is it permanently gives them the boarded tag. And by having the boarded tag, that's what stops our capture abilities from working. Very clever. So it can't be captured. And it now has this ability here, which is the target. Now, I needed to edit this one. Just remembered that we need to edit this one. So we want to get rid of frigates and capital ships. Corvettes and Titans need to go. Put that down to 2. And we can save that one. So one down. So we can say goodbye to our... oh, we already said goodbye to it. Our adapt. And now we can use this one here. So this one here is playing a persistent beam effect. And with a persistent beam effect, as long as the ability is active, it's going to be sending out this effect, this beam. But currently, this beam here, we're going to resave it again, is a Borg beam. Now, I don't know about you guys, but seeing a Borg beam is kind of immersion breaking. So we don't really want to see a Borg beam. We want to see a Klingon type beam to heal up. So we're going to need to change a few things around on this as well. So again, we're going to call this Nem underscore buff underscore repair drone activate. We can call it the same thing because this one's a buff file. Again, I'm going to save this. So here we go, saving that file. Let's see if we can get a bit of music change as well. Yes, I did, Joe, because of the delay. So we've got all our stuff kind of aligned for this. We've got the save now as the right one that we wanted to do. This Nem ability repair drone activate. One of the important things I do need to do is change it to Nem underscore buff. Oh, spell it right. Buff underscore repair drone, because it needs to point at the right file, otherwise Sims will crash when we try to use it. Oh, what do I? But you know what? I'm just having a bad day with my keyboard and stuff today, and I don't know why. Can't type while streaming, clearly. So it points to the right file. So this file here, it's all fine except for when we get to the sounds. So we need to look at muzzle sounds. Okay, so let's have a look for a Klingon ship. Let's have a look at the Corral. Now the Corral doesn't use a beam, so that's probably not going to be too helpful, but we can have a look anyway. I don't think, does she have a beam? I can't really, she does have a beam. Okay, so this is beam. We've got the beam here, so it says beam. Hi Lord Omicron. So we're going to need to use a kind of beam effect here. This is a persistent beam though. It would only be Klingon in origin, not Borg in origin. So the sound, well, Klingon phaser sound. That's going to be the sound we want. For now, we're just going to put this in. What else are we going to need? We want the disruptor impact. Kind of a Borg impact. We need a clean weapon impact. So we're going to change these. And these are applying actual particles, which are in the engine. I don't know if I've got Particle Forge loaded. Let's have a look. If I can show you guys Particle Forge, I will, because I love showing you guys this stuff. I might have Particle Forge. Do I have Particle Forge in my sentence folder? I do have Particle Forge. Let's have a look, see if I can show you a file. Because a lot of you guys are going, what's all these impacts? What's all this stuff that you're showing off? Very, very simple. Why is that 1.8 folder still there? Let's go into Nemesis. Let's go to Particles. So, we were talking about our CLI. So, if we go with KLI. So, Particles. So, we're going to be using certain particle simulations here. So, in this case, we're looking for a CLI weapon disruptor impact. So, if we look for disruptor green impact or disruptor impact there, and we open it, you're probably seeing that flashing and you're like, what's that mean? Where's that coming from? And I just realized it's looking at someone else's folders, which is why it's not showing you guys stuff. But if I look, and I'm only going to do this for one. So we're looking for, let's see, let's cancel that. What are we looking for? We're looking for textures explosion red disruptor. Okay, so we point this back to, because I'm really keen just to show you guys how this all works. So we've got it in our folder, textures, and what did I say it was CLI, wasn't it? CLI. Red. So look at that again. Brain's memory not working. Explosion, sorry. Explosion underscore red disruptor. I'll get there in a minute. Explosion underscore red disruptor. Remember that, guys. We're looking for explosion underscore red disruptor textures. EXP explosion underscore red flare. No. Red disruptor flare. Okay. I'm hoping. That if we. You gonna run? You're not gonna run for me, are you? Red disruptor flare. That's the effector. Bear with me, guys. There we go. Okay. So this. This here is the effect. Got there in the end. Okay? So you guys have now seen the effect. And this is what Particle Forge, which is the in-game tool, allows us to actually do. This allows us to create an effector that... excuse my phone. That does this kind of... pretty effect, and that's just one effect. All right, that's what I want to get through to you guys. That's just one effect that it goes towards, and that's the impact. So every time a beam, this is why it's exciting, every time a beam fires in the game, when you fire a phaser, that from a clear ship, that is the impact that is hitting the enemy ship. So that beautiful pulsing particle is the beam hitting the armor of the model of the other ship. That's just the impact. Obviously, what goes along with that, that's just one particle. And you can see all the stuff that goes into making... These are all effectors that make it actually work. Okay? And that's just one part. That's that... obviously, it's a green impact, so I showed you a red one. But you get the idea. So, when we do a hit effect name, that's what's applying that particular impact. Or, in this case, a green one. And this is where all these hit effect names. You even have sounds as well. So we can apply a sound file. So in this case, I'm just gonna copy all of these sounds over. There we go. And we're gonna need to put a sound count up to 4. Okay. Yeah, Big Bang Theory is my phone I can't speak today. My ringtone on my phone, so I will call the person back. I'm a Big Bang Theory fan, so of course I am. I'm a super geek. I admit that. You guys know this already. So we got some Shield Impact sounds as well. So we can do that. We can add those in. So again, we're just nicking all these things. Let's see if I pause the music. That's probably a good thing to show you that. Let's see if I can find you guys. Again, I'm really interested in showing you these things. The file. So we're looking for a weapon. I think these are these names. I swear these were names right. Are they under weapon? Bear with me, guys. I can't remember if it's in these ones or not. Let's just look for pulse. I can't find the particular one I'm after now. But there you go. This will do as a confirmation. So you can hear that sound, hopefully. So each impact we have a sound file for. Yeah? And that's one of the things I think that sets a mod of free apart from a lot of mods, because not every mod has gone to that level of detail. You know, not every mod has literally created their own sounds for everything. You know, I'm not, again, this is meant in no disrespect to those mods at all, but a lot of mods just prefer to use the impact sounds from the stock game. Yeah, so they're using stock impact sounds. Obviously Ascendancy doesn't, because it's using Star Wars sounds, and Soldiers use Star Wars, but some mods, even for some of the bigger mods, use a lot of stock sounds. But in STA3, there are different sounds. I mean, you could, again, we could do the board. We could do any of these. To the point that if I find, what did I call it? I think it's B underscore something. Let me find you an example. My favorite one I made, if I can find it. It's going to be one of those really annoying ones to find, I bet you. Titan. So even the voices have been made. Where the hell did I put that Borg sound? Borg ambient. Borg. Hyper beam. So we have the hyper beam I'll charge. I actually made this sound myself out of combining it in, this is done in Audacity, believe it or not. Never say that Audacity as a free program is a bad program. So this one. And you're like, Where's the other sound? You mean this one? That's what we mean. So you can. This is what I like about the Sins engine. It's really easy. So we have impact sounds, and we have charging sounds, if fire. You know, there's a lot of sounds, and then there's orders as well, because you've got the orders for the ship. You know, so there's a lot that's gone into making STA3 very, very unique. Got the Star Trek music as well. So if you guys are interested in that stuff, if you just want the music from the game, it's in the sound folder. You can grab it, as you can see. And I just love the fact that a lot of these were made by Max himself. And you know, if Max is watching or watches at some point, that's what makes it really interesting. All it's a quantum. There you go, fed quantifier. Pulse. You know, there's two. I could do this all day playing.
Squadron reporting, Captain.
The Federation sends its best.
The Federation does send its best, it really does. Even the explosions. Hyper beam everywhere. Engines, did you know when you played STA3 that the engines hum differently? Did you know that? I bet you didn't, did you? I bet you guys never thought. And they're all different. This is a Klingon engine. Okay, let's do that again. Klingon engine. Romulan engine. Okay, how about Federation engine? Okay. So, I don't know if you guys are seeing some of this at the moment, because my live stream is showing a really weird black spot from where Particle Forge was open. Let's just close Particle Forge down. So, why are you doing that? Perhaps it's just my live stream, but my live stream is not showing. It's just, are you guys seeing like just a black overlay on the screen at the moment? Let me know if you are seeing that, because that's weird. I don't know how I'm going to fix that one. Dun 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 dun. Maybe we just blank it off and go again. We do that. Dun, back to scene one. Has that cleared it? Don't know what's going on. So we've got quite a few sounds that are in there. When you guys get to catch up with me, hopefully I can show you that. Let's have a look. So we got all these impact effects. It has cleared now on the stream. That's good. Thank God for that. It has cleared. Particle Forge being shit. But we haven't finished yet. So we're back to our cause. Now we have the adaption. So we've got the glows. Okay. So the glows, we want to have Klingon disruptor glows. And that is going to go here, and then we want the core. So let's go to the core. We're going to want the core here. So again, this is changing. It might be, if you guys want to see the cores, let me know. I can show you one of the cores as well. I don't mind. This is your stream as well as mine. I'm not really doing as much work probably as I should be for Nemesis, but if your Nemesis is delayed, you guys won't mind, right? There we go. We've now replaced the very Borg stuff with very Klingon stuff. And we can see that we can actually tile the beam and the beam width. So in this case, how wide is the beam going to be? In this case, it's 130 wide. And that determines how thick the beam is. We can't make it too thick because you're not going to see this in a 2D plane. You make it too thick, it looks weird. Which sometimes, I don't know if you've ever seen the Borg Reaper beam fire, but the width of the hyper beam could be a little bit... Sometimes you get the weird kind of effect sometimes, depending on what angle your camera's at. So that, because everything's in 2D, it just... What the way the game does when you're rotating the camera around, it's still being displayed in 2D, if you like, but it's rotating that 2D effect around. It's really cool. That's how it works. But other than that, they're all pretty much flat effects. Came across the show. Sorry. All right, we'll do that because I'm feeling in the mood to show off some of the stuff. So let's. I'm going to need Particle Forge, guys. So you're going to have to bear with me again because my Particle Forge is currently sitting set up in Ascendancy, unfortunately, because I've been working. Some ascendancy stuff, yay! Not that you guys will be mine if I'm walking on ascendancy. Working on ascendancy, that's the proper terminology, Bane. Get it right. So we were going to look at the K glow. Glow. I think, was it called? What was it called? Let's go back to the file. Cle Disruptor. There we go. So we're looking for Cle Dis. Where is the particle simulation file for Cle Disruptor Glow? Actually, is that a disruptor glow or is that a texture? I think it's just a texture, isn't it? Let me have a look. That's a texture. What am I doing? What are you doing, Bane? What are you doing? Let's have a look at the texture. It's not in Particle Forge. Don't even need Particle Forge. Because it's a texture, Bane. You're thinking of particles. Right. So, this is when my Windows completely fails to find the file that I actually want to find. Okay. Come on. Fine. Don't find the file. That's because you're in Ascendancy, Bane. Get out of Ascendancy, Bane. Get into STA3, Bane. All right. Talking to yourself as always, as well as talking to you guys. There we go. So, Cle. Disruptor beam. There we go. So we can open that. Just gonna wait for Photoshop to load up. Yeah, Particle Forge is a bit of a pain. It should close momentarily. This is a beam glow. There you go. That is, after all that, you guys, that is a beam glow. Okay. So that's what it's applying. Let's see if we can do this again. There's another one here. Hang on, did I just open that one? This one? There's the core. So you've got the glow, which is kind of like the outer edge. And then you have the core, which is the inner edge. So that is a beam that's going to the station. This is the beam you will see. If you see this beam from a Burrell drone healing the station, you will know that you need to deal with it. Okay? And I think that looks pretty cool. I think everyone will agree, hopefully, with that. I remember this is being applied as an effect on our file. So that's what we're applying. We're applying these. And so we're going, please, Mr. Sins, apply this beam width at 130 across the screen at that target over there. And it will repeat the beam. It will repeat it. So it, that's what makes it look like it's actually a varied beam. You see the little white static bits in it because that's going to be repeated all the way to the target. So, I think that's pretty cool. I think we showed you some cool. I'm quite happy. This, I started the stream. I didn't realize, actually. Will I be showing this stuff off? But yeah, I am. So I'm reasonably happy with my achievements. So anyway, we need to get back on because I do actually need to finish these abilities. That was my set target for the stream, was actually getting some abilities. So we need to create Nem underscore. We can't call it buff hull adapt on target. No, that won't work for us. So we are going to do Nem underscore buff, and we're going to do repair drone, and we're going to do we'll do repair drone target. Yes. Okay. Because it's going to be targeting the station. I have no idea, Lord. Oh my God. There is a 30-second delay in the stream because I don't. Although the internet is pretty good that I've got now, there is a slight delay in the stream to, because you get drop frames otherwise. I don't like to be like right up to the minute. I think. if I had a dedicated line, like if I was Shaq and paid for my own one-to-one contention like line, and bear in mind that's like £1,000 to get that kind of line a month, then it would be different. I would just stream live without a delay. But because I'm still on version contention ratios and all that, even though I've got very good connection, I was 200 meg down, 20 up, I'd still prefer to just like keep a delay in. So anyway, then buff repair drone target. We need to save this file now. Okay, here's our Borg file, but we're just gonna again save this as our nem underscore buff underscore repair drone target dot entity, and put that up. So there is repair drone target. Now we've got repair drone target, and we don't really have to change anything here. We will change the numbers at some point. Okay. The sound ID. We can't be having it play an adapt shield sound. That's just not going to work for us. Let's go back to our sound folder. Let's see. Can we find a sound for the Klingons? Let's have a look. Klingon. They have a Bastion shield sound. That sounds quite good. Let's have a look into the original Borg sound. So there was an adapt shield. That sounds cool, but we need a Klingon one. We do need that. So we could have the Bastion shield. Give me your thoughts, guys. I'm not sure if that's going to be the one we want or not. Is there any other Klingon shield? There doesn't seem to be many Klingon shield ones, actually. There's a healing. Is there a healing? Oh, that's quite cool. The ability shield up. I quite like that one. So we've got Bastion shield. We've got shield up so far. Let's see. What else do we have? Lots of Romulan ones. Shield. Let's type the word. See if we can find out the word shield. How many have shield? The impacts we've got. I quite like the shield track from the Romulans. That, I think we should use that one. That's what I think. I think we should do the ability shield drain and use that one. I don't like the shield drain effect. I don't know. I'm thinking the shield drain sounds quite cool. So I'm gonna wait to see what you guys say, but for the moment, while I'm waiting for you guys to say, I'm just gonna put that R underscore ability underscore. Look, you guys are helping make the mod. I'm gonna put shield drain, but if you guys tell me which one you prefer, I promise I'll change it to that one. Yes, that's good. So to wait, see what you guys come up with in chat. Da-da-da-da. You're just gonna see me for like 30 seconds looking at you guys waiting, going, what are you gonna put in the chat? I can see myself actually just playing the sound to you guys now. That's gonna be fun for you guys. Yay! Da-da-da-da-da-da. Oh, we've got to the bit where I'm telling you. If you guys tell me what you want, I'll put it in. So anyway, I'm going to carry on. If you guys tell me to change it, it'll change. So there we have those files. Okay, so we have our repair drone target, our repair drone activate, okay, and we have our NEM buff repair drones that's created. We have our NEM ability repair drone activate, which goes to repair drone activate. So we have that, and we have our frigate bro drone. There's the frigate bro drone. We have our ability uncap and our ability NEM ability repair drone activate. So it's all in there, okay. So that's done. I'm happy with that. All right, happy with repair drone activate. Let's get rid of the corral. Don't need that. Let's look back at our restore files. Okay, so what else have we got? We don't need any of this damaged stuff. I'm going to get rid of that for now. M buff restore shields. Then buffer and shockwave, rapid fire destructor, don't need that. Don't need ability damage. All these damage chains. So we got our buff repair drones there. Happy about that. That one's working, we know that. So we got our repair drone, expert repair drone target. So let's move these back to the other view now. Now that we've closed things down. Just so we've got them all ready. So ability restore, which goes to restore self, which goes to restore chain one. Here's restore chain one. Then we need our restore chain states. So let's go back to the states. That's in sound bane, not in the file that we need. So we want states. So let's find states. There's our states, restore chain states. So we're going to edit that again. Now here's the issue with restore chain states. The restore chain states has too many instant actions in. When I made this, I was going a little bit mad and I forgot that there was that limit. Remember, I said the limit of 5. So we can't have a restore chain, just a restore chain states. We need a two states. The patch Omicron is actually a patch for Final Frontier. So if you download Final Frontier, you download the patch, that fixes a lot of bugs, pulls out some gravity, fixes some of the maps that cause crashes. So it's a good patch to get. So if you are a fan of Final Frontier, do download the patch, because that fixes a lot of the issues. Okay. If you use the icons patch as well, it won't matter. There goes my Big Bang Theory again. So we need to split this into two. So I'm going to create a new file again, and I'm just going to grab all of it. So we've got it all here. So this is a copy, a duplicate, if you like, of the file. Okay, there it is. And I'm going to save this as NEM buff restore chain states number 2.entity. And then once that's saved, there it is. I can then start splitting the file out. So we know that there's an 80, 70, 60, 50, 40, 30, 20. So I'm going to take out these four states here, instant action states here. Okay. We're going to cut those out. Okay. And go from there. And that gives us now 1, 2, 3, 4. And we're going to change the instant action numbers down to 4 in this file. And that's at 80, 70, 60. That's our 80, 70, 60 done. We're going to go to our clone that we made. So we've done 80, 70, 60. Yeah, we don't need that. So we're going to get that. Now we're going to ignore the buff chain one at the top. And I'll tell you why in a second. So we've done our 80, 70, 60. We're going to remove those three there. Okay. And then we're going to change this to 5. And we're going to save this one. And you notice that we have our 50, 40, 30, 20 there. But we also kept, as I said, this one here, restore chain one. And the reason but that needs to be kept, remember, this is about creating that loop, that message to the buff that, hey, you're going to go back to yourself because you're going to keep applying this buff in case the percentages of health change, whether you guys damage it down more or the drones heal it up more. These are going to change. So you need to loop the buff to be able to do this. Yeah, okay, so that's why we've created two. The issue is, we go back to restore chain one here. Currently, restore chain one does not point to number two. So what we need to add here is we need to copy this instant action here. So there we go. We're going to copy the instant action. There we go. We now have two. It's very important. Sins loves numbers. All right. You've got to tell it that it's got two instant actions to perform. And we're going to add states number two. Okay, to it. So we have buff restore chain states, which is our first one. We have buff restore chain states two, which is our second one. Okay. And that is the two files that we wanted. I think we've done some good work today, guys. I'm just aware that we've been streaming for quite a while. I'm going to call it there. There's going to be no in-game. But what I may do is next week, at some point, I may actually show this all working in-game if I get a chance on a separate stream. So we'll call it Nemesis Coding Time with Bane Part 2. But I hope this has given you a little bit of an insight into the coding of STA3. I hope you've enjoyed seeing some of this. If you want to see more of this kind of stuff, let me know and I'll make sure I cover some more. Maybe I'll even do some ascendancy as well. But once again, I want to thank you guys for watching, and do let me know in the comment section when it's up on YouTube anything you'd like to see covered in the future. But thanks for watching, guys. I'm gonna say goodbye and sign out.